If you still haven't put AF into production, you may still be in the planning stages, and one of the things you may need to do is to move the AF SQL database from, oh, let's say you've got it on an internal kind of a testing only platform. So, you know, this is normally where you do all your normal testing. And then for production, you actually like to put this on a different computer. So let's say you've got a different computer in your network. You know, this is a computer that's running your production version of SQL Server. So, you know, this is going to be a SQL box, just like your original SQL box. And what you simply need to do is, now that the staging has been completed, you're going to go ahead and move everything that's configured on here, take that and move that over to here. And the way we're going to do that is with a backup and a restore. There's a couple of things we're going to do. We'll do a real simple backup here, you know, back this up to a file, and then move that backup over to here, and then use the restore capabilities to bring that back into SQL Server. As you might guess, there are some other things that need to be configured. For example, if you remember, on this box right here, there was a connection string. This connection string has to be fixed so that it knows where the new server is. So whatever this server name is over here, this instance name, that's going to be something you're going to have to modify in that connection string, that configuration. Now, those of you who already have AF up and running and you've got SQL in place, you actually may have to go through this as well. You know, there may be a day when this machine right here, it's just not big enough anymore, or it's going to fail, or it needs to be upgraded in some way, or it just outright fails. At that point, you're going to be installing a new SQL server, and on that SQL server, you're going to be putting the backups that you've got from here. So one way or another, it's going to be useful to know how to take this AF database, back it up, as you see right here, and bring that over here onto SQL Server, onto a new instance of SQL Server in a new location. And then, of course, how do you fix AF to recognize the new location? So let's take a look at how we do this. First of all, we have backup mechanisms within a SQL Server itself that we're going to take advantage of. So let's just look at a before and after here. Here's our AF database, or a list of AF databases in my current configuration here. I've got, what is it, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 of these AF databases. And if we take a look at these are the ones that I've used in all of our examples in this class. So, you know, here's something that needs to be backed up that we potentially are going to be moving from this machine to something else. So in order to do that, the first thing I need to do is go into the Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio and make a backup. So I've connected to this. I'm going to go into under here. I'm going to choose that database called PyFD. Within PyFD, with a right click, I should be able to choose tasks. And the task I'm going to choose is backup. Now this allows me to configure how the backup works and, of course, where we're actually going to put it. So this is going to be stored right here. That's going to be the name of the file. I'll go ahead and say OK. This is going to go ahead and execute that backup for me. Yeah, there we go. It's executed the backup. And now we're ready to move this to a new location. So to demonstrate in this case, what I'm going to do is just get rid of this table right here. Get rid of, essentially delete the... Now remember, this isn't deleting AF. This is deleting the AF SQL database. So this SQL database, this is on a different machine, the machine that's running SQL Server. And this does mean, of course, if I do delete this table, then AF is certainly going to break. And what we should see is some errors thrown over here when I do this. Now, I forgot to make the point, though, before you do this backup, if this is, you know, this is going to be your good backup, then you should probably kick all of your users off before you do this backup so that nobody's in the middle of writing something to AF as you do the backup. Now, before I'm going to do anything drastic like that, though, let's just make sure that I've actually got a good backup. So we'll take a look. This is going to be under Program Files, Microsoft SQL Server, under this MS SQL 10. Now, that's going to be different depending on which version you're using. And then MS SQL, and then backup. And here's my backup. As you can see, it's got today's date. It's the 25th. We've got a good backup. We should be ready to go. I'll go ahead and break the existing AF by just getting rid of this PyFD database. Now, I'm going to go ahead and delete this database simply to demonstrate how this works. But this is something you would typically, well, you would never do this back home. I would never delete my original until I'm absolutely sure it's been reinstalled on the and restored on the destination. So please don't do this at home. Actually, if you are doing staging and testing purposes, again, with those qualifications, don't do this unless you really do intend to delete this database. If you do have to do that, you're going to have to shut down AF first, because of course AF is keeping this in use. So you'd have to go to the AF server and stop the AF service. But I'm going to go ahead and do that, again, just for purposes of demonstration. Now, I just shut down AF on my AF server. Notice immediately, first of all, this is going to throw some errors over here. Cannot connect because it's not running. So if I were to try to go out and find anything in here, that's not going to work. That's simply not going to work. So it looks like I've done it correctly. That's interesting. This looks like it's done it correctly, which is to basically I broke AF, which is what I was trying to do here. And let me break it for real. Let me go ahead and delete this database. Again, don't do this at home. So I'll go ahead and delete that. There we go. So now let's demonstrate the other side of it. How do we restore? Now in this section on restoring this to another SQL database, you'll see a mention that you have to do these prerequisite steps to the manual installation of the AF SQL database. You'll find those over in the PyAF User's Guide. There is a section on updating or creating this AF SQL database manually instead of doing it during the normal AF install. Well, in order to do that manually, there are a couple of prerequisite steps, like, for example, that if you recall, there is an AF servers local Windows group that gets created during the regular AF install, and that's something you're going to have to do manually. There's some other things we're going to specify, like, for example, how to run the service, the AF service. And then you'll see some other things. Some of these things are duplicated in the instructions we're about to follow. So, for example, recreating this AF user is something you'll see in these instructions as well. So let's go ahead and demonstrate what you would do here. And I'm going to start by going into the SQL Server Management Studio. So I'm going to choose from this databases option, choose this Restore Database. And we need to find wherever that backup was done. Now, if you remember, I'm going to specify the source. I'm going to go out and find that file. So let me go ahead and browse for that. Yeah, here it is. It's actually found my backup. Now, if you're on a different machine with a different version, you may have to go out and browse for where this backup actually is. But this is assuming now that you've added this file to the correct directory in your destination copy of SQL Server. This is exactly the same directory I used for the backup, but let's just pretend this is a different machine. I found the right file. I'll go ahead and say OK. Now, contained within that one backup, there were a couple of, in fact, instances where I did a full backup. I'm going to choose this option right here, the second one. That's the more recent one, if we take a look at the date. Now, I also need to specify which database I'm actually going to be restoring, and I'm restoring this PIFD database. All this looks good. I've got the right time and the right date there and the right backup. I'll go ahead and do the restore. As you can see, it's executing. But we're not finished yet. There's still a couple of things that have to be done. There we go. It was restored successfully. If we look under here, we'll see PIFD databases there. But before I can actually do this and start up the AF server again, if this were a different machine, what you would have to do is go into the security section. And you're going to have to delete, and then if it's already there, and then add this user called AF servers. Now, you will need to create that user again, that AF servers login, I should say, not user. So this login is going to be based on the Windows group called AF servers. Under object types, I have to make sure I look for groups, because this is a Windows user group or a security group. There we go. We found it. I deleted it and now added it back. That's part of doing the restore. And now I do need to supply this PIFD database with this role called DBAF server. That's the role that's associated with that login. Now the last step is to go back to your AF server. And on the AF server, you'll find under this directory right here, program files pypcaf, this configuration file. Now this is what you would normally edit to put the connection string point, or to point the connection string at the proper server. That's the SQL server. In this case, it hasn't changed. It's still the same computer on my instance of the AF server here, so I don't need to make a change to that. But normally during the restore, you would do that. So the big finish to this would be, let's go ahead and start up the AF server again and see if it points to the correct restored AF database and if I can launch the Pi System Explorer. Okay, now I've started up the AF service on my AF server, and I'm going to go ahead and start up the Pi System Explorer. And let's see if we can connect correctly and if the databases that we backed up are restored. And there we go. As you can see, we still have those seven databases, and the structures have been, well, in this case, just restored, but this would be where you would see it move to a new destination.